Welcome to another interesting Power BI tutorial. Today we will discuss Power BI Gantt charts and create one, explaining each and every step in detail. This is most probably the most detailed tutorial on Power BI Gantt chart you will find online for free. So stay tuned with us, and let's start. To create a Gantt chart in Power BI, you need data in this format. These columns are essential. You need to have at least tasks, their start dates, and their end dates, to create a Gantt chart with minimal information. Without these three columns, you cannot create a meaningful Gantt chart. Tasks appear like this in a Gantt chart. On the top of the Gantt chart, there is a timeline. Using the start and end date, tasks are shown on this timeline. If you have tasks pertaining to various projects, you can have a column for projects as well. Repeat the name of project with each task, just like projects in this column. Projects will then appear over here, as group parent, which can be expanded and collapsed to display or hide the task in each project. When projects are collapsed, the tasks disappear, and a single line is displayed starting from the start date of first task and ending at the end date of last task of that project. If you want to display progress or percentage of completion of each task, you can add a progress column as well. Here 1 means 100%, 0 means not yet started, and any value in between shows percentage of completion. The progress is displayed within each task by using a different color. A task with 100% progress or 0% progress will be displayed in one color, while a task with progress other than these will have two different colors, one depicting the complete portion, and the other representing the portion still in process. You can include teams or individuals by their names, designations, or titles related to the task in the Gantt chart. Here we have included the names of persons responsible for each task. These resources are shown next to their relevant task in the Gantt chart like this. You can add another column for status. There could be three values in status column: complete, in process, and not started. You can also use this column as legend in the Gantt chart, in which case, each task will show this status by color, making it easy to determine which task is complete, in process, or not yet started. Finally, you can add milestones to your data which will be displayed in your Gantt chart. Just as here, we entered a milestone on the 8th of May, when exterior was completed in our building project. The milestone will appear in Gantt chart like this. It will appear on the timeline in the Gantt chart using the start and end date. These two columns are not required in the Gantt chart. They are used to calculate the progress from the start and end dates. The first column shows the difference of start and end date in days, while the second column shows the difference of today and start date in days. Then in the progress column, we calculate progress from these two values. Now, let's show you how to create a Gantt chart in Power BI using this data. We will start our dashboard by importing a Gantt chart from a file. Gantt chart is not a part of Power BI by default. You must get one from the internet. After importing the Gantt chart, it will be available in the Visuals pane. First, we will enter a title for our dashboard, using the text box visual from Insert menu. Now we can add our Gantt chart custom visual to our dashboard, and place it nicely below the title, covering the entire page. This is all the information that we can provide to the Gantt chart, most of which is available in our dataset. First of all, we will add the project name field to the parent area. And after that, we will add the task field to the task area. But this information is almost useless without the start date and the end date, which will tell us when a task is starting and ending. Also, tasks will be sorted from top to bottom, based on start date and the end date, which are currently sorted alphabetically. As soon as the start date and the end date is added, tasks are sorted accordingly, and they start showing their start and end date. Now the Gantt chart is quite meaningful, although most information is still missing. The duration field is not necessary, because we have provided the start and end date, the difference of which is the duration of the task. The percentage completion field is, however, very important, as it will display the percentage of task completed and remaining. We have a progress field, which shows the percentage completion, which we will add here. Tasks now show a progress bar, reflecting the percentage of completion. In the resource area, we will add the resource field, in which we have the name of resource person relevant to the task. It will appear next to their task. In the tooltips area, we can add any file or fields, which we want to display in the tooltip text when the mouse is hovered over a task. Most of the important information is already included. We can add more, such as status. And now, when we hover over the task, we can also see if it is complete, in process, or not started yet. Milestone is an important event. It is shown with different graphic. We have declared this task as milestone. As soon as we will add the milestone field, the graphic will change, recognizing that this is not a task but a milestone. Finally, as you can see, all tasks have same colors no matter if they are complete, in process, or not started yet. To make the Gantt chart even better, we can add the status field to the legend area. After which you will notice that based on status of the task, different color has been assigned to the task. Now we can easily and clearly see which tasks are complete, which are in process, and which have not started yet. We can also click on the status in the legend to further highlight the tasks. And with this, we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.